Hello everyone, welcome back. This is Rando Geek. So we have some excellent news regarding T-Mobile's network. The long-awaited 2.5 gigahertz licenses from Auction 108 is set to blaze up the sky. Apparently, over the next few days, T-Mobile will be lighting up massive amounts of new 5G spectrum that it won in at Auction 108, we're being told. This is excellent news for T-Mobile. They've been waiting a really long time for this, and they've really gotten kicked around when it comes to this purchase. They spent a lot of money. They've been forced to sit on it for so long because the FCC apparently lost their licenses to go ahead and make a decision to release the spectrum. Between that and AT&T trying to stand in the way, and there's just so much negativity and hate towards T-Mobile for just trying to create a really big, strong network. A lot of criticism towards T-Mobile's rural coverage. This should hopefully make some change to that. This should offer much better coverage to customers in rural areas and also give them a greater opportunity to reach new potential customers. For those customers that do struggle with rural coverage, that have had T-Mobile in the past, were not satisfied with services indoors or in certain cities and states, hopefully the image of that, the perception of T-Mobile's rural coverage not being the greatest, will start to change. What does this mean for other carriers? Well, I don't know. That's what's going to be so exciting about this. To see if this actually does anything for them, if it makes the coverage better, overall, the network conditioning stronger. And we're going to see how many customers, you know, start to sign up for T-Mobile or shift from other carriers over to T-Mobile. It's going to be very interesting because some customers feel that T-Mobile has the best package when it comes to pricing and perks that are being offered for plans. There are some customers that go with Verizon and AT&T because they're more reliable and dependable. But what would happen if T-Mobile, the company offering a cheaper plan or more perks for the money, should I say, starts to become a more reliable and stronger network? Will that change T-Mobile's pricing? Maybe. Will other carriers change their pricing? Obviously, they're going to continue to work on their networks, right? Verizon is going to get stronger. I'm sure AT&T is going to continue to advance. AT&T is just a little bit slower with their buildouts, but indeed, it is going well. Whatever they're touching is turning to gold, and Verizon is starting to move real quick with their buildouts. So this is getting hot, is what I'm trying to say. T-Mobile, Verizon especially, are the two that we got to look out for. Those are the two to keep our eyes on in 2024. I think this is really good news. I think they deserve it. It is a shame that they had to give up the 20 megahertz of spectrum in regards to the Hawaiian islands of, what is it, Kiaui and Maui. I think they could have waited a little bit. They were going to get that spectrum. But I guess if it forced the hands, if it basically forced the FCC to go ahead and just make the decision and not delay any longer, because who knows, even though the bill was signed by Congress, the president, they could have tried to dance around this for another year or so, and T-Mobile was just done with it. They just wanted their spectrum. They're losing money. There's a lot of customers that were probably leaving because they're not getting good rural coverage, and because the rural coverage is not available, there's a whole customer base that they're not making money off of. So I think that's why T-Mobile was like, we don't care. We want our spectrum. We bought it. It's ours. Just give it up. We'll make a sacrifice and we'll move on with it and we'll live with it and deal with it. So hopefully this works out for them. I really want to see how this is going to pan out. So it's going to be very interesting when speed test results come out, coverage map testing comes out, customers speak out and say how the network's been. This is going to be interesting stuff. I'll link this article for you down below in the description. It is from Fierce Wireless. You can read up on it. There's some other good stuff in here about, I guess, some plans of what they're happy, what they've done so far, and what they plan to do in regards to continuing to build out 5G. But more importantly, this update was just literally to express my excitement towards the long-awaited 2.5 gigahertz licenses being released. And yeah, if you guys notice improvements with your network over the next couple of days, if you're in a rural area where T-Mobile hasn't been good and you start noticing it, feel free to come back and let us know in a comment section down below. do me a favor. If you like this video and you like the News on His channel, just give us a like. That's all we really expect. You know, a lot of this here, we don't ask for donations. I'm not doing that. If you guys want to do it, you can. I'm not asking, but the like, I appreciate that. The comments are always welcome. And just your support watching is good enough for me. As always, thank you guys so much for stopping by and watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye for now.